More and more people are trading in their two-story, multi-bedroom suburban habitats for a more humble homestead. It's called the tiny house revolution, and I, for one, am completely captivated by this movement towards the simplicity of life.
While some are drawn to the prospect of financial freedom or the smaller ecological footprint it offers, many are finding it also represents a milestone in personal development. This was certainly true for Vina Lustado. A designer with over 20 years of experience, Vina turned her energies from corporate high-end projects to smaller scale designs that could make a positive difference. She is part of the growing tiny house movement, designing and building her own little piece of paradise. I met up with Vina at her tiny home in Ojai, where she gave me a personal tour of this remarkable piece of architecture.
Your home is absolutely beautiful, Vina, and I look at it and I see modernness. I see the beautiful siding, the windows and the doors. Tell me about the exterior of the home.
You know, one of the qualities that I really wanted to strive for in terms of the exterior of the home was having it passive solar heating and cooling, because I wanted it to be environmentally friendly without artificial heating and cooling needs. So it's south facing. A lot of the light comes in naturally through all the French doors and windows. All of the cedar siding that you see on the outside is actually domestically sourced, so it's not coming from South America with ipe, really exotic woods. All the material here that you see for the decking is actually recycled. None of it was bought. It was all from fallen trees. So we just resanded it and just put a good stain on it, and now it's just a new life. And that's one of the important things that I wanted to express in my house, is to use reclaimed materials as much as possible. So again, we're preserving our natural resources.
By using reclaimed materials, Vina has managed to create a beautiful space, and it's evident inside the home.
Okay, Didi, here it is. So this is the great room, which actually is an all room for me. It has the living room and the dining room, and I actually do yoga in this little space also.
Very efficient. So it's a living room, dining room, and a yoga space, and a workspace.
And a workspace, my little office, a media space so that I can watch my, you know, entertainment and DVDs and everything else on my laptop. So it's very efficient, and that's one of the important components of tiny living.
Now, talking about tiny living, how many square feet are we talking about here?
This is 140 square feet for the first floor, and the mezzanine level is actually 80 square feet for the loft.
Who knew that you would put a tiny home with the second level in the same sentence? But
it's
it seems possible,
stories.
Right? I really like the light tones in here. It really gives it a feeling that it is more expansive.
Mm-hmm. And actually, that's another component to tiny living. You don't want it to be too busy, because it is such a small space. I really minimize the amount of stuff with colors and different things going on.
And look at the view out of the double doors. This is fantastic. So it's, even though it's a smaller space, storage and the utilization of great little pieces of furniture mm-hmm. like this make it very friendly.
Yeah, it's really important to have your space really multifunctional, because really this is what I have for most everything. Well, this is the kitchen, Didi. In kitchen spaces such as this, there's a lot of organization that happens because we need as much functionality in the space as possible. So for instance, this is my wardrobe cabinet, and it has all of my...
Your clothes are in the kitchen!
Wardrobe.
Oh, wow!
Exactly.
Okay!
And there's little drawers that I use in order to
Perfect.
Maximize the space.
Who knew there'd be clothes in a kitchen?
And it's actually quite functional, too.
That's great. I was going to ask you where your clothes were going to go. Well, there they are. Okay.
And then the rest of these are just little spaces for more more storage.
And you're able to put your dishes and your cups up in a higher place, which is wonderful.
Yes, and it's important that it's kept open so it feels more spacious, and obviously as much light as possible.
Oh, okay. So instead of putting cabinets with doors, which would make it feel bulky and shut off, the shelves themselves have lend themselves to be more open and airy.
Exactly.
And what's behind this door?
This door is actually my bathroom.
Oh, okay.
It's a full bathroom that has a full tiled shower, lots of windows, so there is a lot of natural light coming in. And then composting toilet, so it's very environmentally friendly. So there's no water involved. It's there's no black water. It actually just goes straight to the gray water system below the trailer so that I recycle all the water that I use.
Vina, I'm sold. I'm definitely sold on living the tiny house lifestyle. Vina is the perfect example of someone taking their passion for simplicity and ecology and turning it into a design for sustainability. An easy lesson on how we can make a difference and impact our world one tiny house at a time.